folks, if I end up on the pole, you know what to do. If I end up on the stage bleeding, still a funny show. Guys, that seat has to go back again and again. Perfect. A little bit towards Whakatane again. Perfect. Here we go. Here comes the countdown in English. 3, 2, 1, let go! Come on, I'm doing it! You guys don't realise how windy the nor'wester is up here.
Well, Christchurch has had it here since 1994, and the city bought it 3 years ago to make sure that we retained it here in the city.
19 years, I've seen it evolve when I've been here as the Court Theatre as an actor, so I've seen this thing grow into this great, huge, probably one of the best festivals of its nature in the world, so, and it's here in Christchurch.
Who would have believed it would have gone ahead? Isn't it fabulous?
Well, I think it's one of the few festivals in the world that can bring so much hilarity to a city where everybody can enjoy themselves for a whole 10 days and experience stuff that they never have before.
But it's inclusive, all ages, so you can come with your family, you can come with your boyfriend, you can come with your kids.
That's fantastic. Yeah, it's great. We've got to carry this on.
This is my first one.
I love seeing the street performers from all over the world, and I love how people just laugh. They don't care. They just laugh.
Like, everyone needs to come and see it.
We are so excited. Super.
It's going to be the best Buskers
ever. Super duper excited.
If you want to see five balls, say yeah!
Okay.
The buckets are coming around.
Oh, and the people that don't pay, I hope you run out of gas on your way home.
Yeah.
I'm going to ask for 3 volunteers. 3 volunteers to help me out on stage. Raise your hands. You know the value of entertainment.
The World Buskers Festival
is regarded as one of the best.
It's one of the biggest and best World Buskers Festivals.
One of the best in the world without the crowds that are obviously some of the best in the world.
This is one of the bigger festivals of this type.
The amazing talent in the show is fabulous.
To see the other acts, interact with the other acts.
There's so many world-class acts.
Possibly the biggest sense of community to it.
And with here, it's like they're like, we're ready. You know, we want to be the audience. The
audiences are excellent.
Audiences, that they really come out and they really support it.
Constantly entertained and surprised and shocked.
Well, it is one of the best in the world. It's one of the top 3 or 4 in the world. There's no doubt about it.
It's got world in its name.
It just puts Christchurch, New Zealand, on the map.
Heaps of fun. It really brings the city to life.
I just love Buskers. Great opportunity, great thing for Christchurch.
It's embraced by Cantabrians, isn't it?
And everyone gets right into it.
It's not sport. Fantastic.
I'm excited to see how this goes, how this works. I'm excited about the lineup this year because they're all so good. So good. Buskers Festival started in Christchurch in 1994. It was a small street performers festival. The center city used to be laid out really well for street performance. It had nice big areas where the public naturally gathered. It had shops with awnings over it that provided shade. It was easy to move from one performance site to another. I've kind of always wanted a portion of the festival in Hagley Park. Well, I appreciate the city and Victoria Square and Cathedral Square and even the mall. I thought, well, to have a concentrated area, a big hub, would be a fantastic thing for this festival.
So we've decided to transform Hagley Park, which is in the middle of Christchurch, into Busker Park. For most of the reasons, it's because we no longer have a central city, and it's been quite an extraordinary journey, I guess, watching the city move with earthquakes and seeing. After the first one, we thought maybe we'd be able to be back in there soon, but after some time, we realised slowly that we weren't going to get back in there, and the red zone, as they call it, is still very much the red zone. And we have decided to build a whole busker village in Hagley Park where we'll bring our venues to the park and have a one-stop sort of shop place to have fun from the day to the night. You can come here from 10 till midnight and never have to leave, get your food, get your laughs, your music. So yeah, we're going to give it a go and think it's going to be pretty cool.
I think it's really great having the Buskers Festival in Hagley Park. It's a lot more enclosed and security seem to be handling it a lot better. And I think the vibe is really nice here because it's right next to town, so people are coming in and they're having a really nice time and then going out and having more fun out there. It's really good.
I like it because it's more of like a family-oriented area, so everyone knows Hagley Park and everyone knows that it's a big area, so there's so much more variety of stuff that happen and there's just so much more going on. It makes the place feel a lot more like lifting. It's good.
It looks like this lady here farted and you're hanging back from here, so just play. This is like a no-go zone. You come on in, mate, with a good, the beautiful shirt. And, yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, I mean, she didn't. She didn't fart, just so you know. She's your mum. She is gassy.
There's never been any doubt in our mind that we had to put something on for the people of Christchurch. The Stronger Christchurch Rural Buskers Festival, as it's named this year, which is pretty cool, is something that is within the fabric of Christchurch society, I guess. It's free and it brings all parts of the city together, whether you're, you know, 90 or 9, or whether you've got a disability, whether you're don't even have a sense of humour, you will actually find yourself cracking up with people that you don't know standing next to you. So I think it's just something we had to do, and it's something that the city really desired. A lot of people are quite surprised we're doing it, to be honest. They kind of can't believe we've done it, but for us it was never a question, it was just a matter of how.
Hi everybody, my name is Bernie Starling.
I'm Chartreuse Wilkinson Swords.
And together we are the backup dancers.
Yeah.
Last year we only got to perform on the concrete.
Yeah.
And it was really hard and we were really gutted.
A lot more bruises. I've got some bruises here. I was covered in bruises last time.
All over, her face, everything.
Yeah, because of the concrete. So we're loving it. The grass is soft.
Woo! Don't mind me, just the hair.
Sorry about that.
It's kind of a drag.
No, we love it here. We love this park setup. It's great.
And put it this way, we're the most famous we've ever been.
Yeah,
here,
we
so
feel quite
we're
special.
We're quite happy.
You know,
we just need to find
we would
husbands.
Find
husbands, and then we'll be fine.
Yeah, our lives will be made, pretty much.
You know anyone?
So you out there?
I'm looking.
Look at this.
So she.
I've got boobs and I've got tattoos.
I've got the F.
And I can dance a little bit.
I traveled to a few Canadian festivals and talked to a lot of people, a lot of street performers, a lot of other festival directors who produce circus shows. I just started to develop it just to suit the city, really, to suit the way that the city was laid out and to suit what people liked here. I figured out pretty quick that the population here likes silly, nonsense, ridiculous comedy the most.
I wonder where my Gracie is tonight. I wonder how my baby is tonight. I wonder where she's gone and how she's getting on. I wonder why my baby doesn't ride.
So we've had an amazing response in terms of some of the best artists in the world have decided to come back this year of all years. And most of our talent had only just left last year before the February earthquake, so it was quite close to home for some of them. They've come back and they're pretty up for making people laugh. It's hard for them to understand what the city is going through. I think it's hard for the city to understand what it's going through. So some of them are a little bit nervous. Some of them are trying to understand what it could be like if an earthquake happens and they're on stage on, you know, a unicycle. But others are pretty much kind of down with it, and we're just making sure everyone takes their time, does what they have to do. It's I think this city's very compassionate with quakes, and so yeah, there's no right or wrong way with how to deal with them, so it's a nice open atmosphere around the whole thing.
My name's Ben, I perform as Benny B. This year I'm performing a show where I get people to play a family of ducks and I dress up as a shark and chase them around, and then a little boy with a water pistol shoots the shark and saves the day. That's very cute.
Hello, I'm Hilby, the skinny German juggle boy. I'm obviously from Germany. I do a variety circus skill show and I'm proving that Germans can be funny.
I'm Chris.
I'm Cable.
We are Funny Bones.
Yeah.
Our show consists of a lot of physical comedy and try to keep it original. Giant puppetry, breakdance, mime, really kind of hard to explain, but it's good stuff.
Hey, how's it going? My name's Famous Seamus. This here is my younger brother, Shauntastic.
And we are Lords of Strut.
Right, my name's Angus, and I'm in the Circus Fireman.
My name's Matilda, and I also am in the Circus Fireman. We do an act where we stand on ladders and juggle fire and some acrobatics and juggling.
Hi, I'm Devil Dan, and I do a paddleball show. It's an amazing display of acrobatics and aerial intrigue.
My name's Jonathan Taylor, and
I'm Anne Goldman.
We're the Daredevil Chicken Club.
Also known as Honeymoon Cabaret.
Also known as the La Tigre Blue people.
And La Dolce Flamingo.
And host to the burlesque show.
In the program, he's called The Lackey.
We started back in 2001.
Well, he started first.
The Daredevil Chicken Club was born on the streets of Spain.
Barcelona.
Mm-hmm. And we ran out of money. We were just touring Europe, kind of our first big trip together. And I said, why don't we do street shows to extend our trip as long as we can? We agreed to put a show together, and we kind of fit it into that format so it would work. And we lasted a couple more weeks.
Yeah.
And then from then on, it was just, you know, doing street pitches in Sydney and Boston and San Francisco.
Mm-hmm. Pier 39, Faneuil Hall.
And then we started doing festivals. And in 2004 was our first year here. So the Honeymoon Cabaret is like the most current version of our show. And if people remember back in 2004, the show is very different. We're still kind of being the same characters. And so in this tent, we're doing like a smaller indoor version of the Honeymoon Cabaret.
It's kind of like the best of.
Yes.
Love is magic. That's kind of the working title.
I mean, every year, every festival, it evolves because we're trying to keep it alive and improv a bit and change it.
La Tigre Bleu.
3 years we've had this little mini venue tour the United States. And we've been wanting to bring it down here. It's just really expensive,
to bring the whole thing.
So what they did was the festival found a used tent for really cheap, and now we are going to kind of convert it into a La Tigre style venue.
Like that we dress our tent with, you know, the inside hangings, the art, and we're setting it up with another partner. And obviously, well, this is a different shaped tent, so some of it's going to be, you know, engineered on the spot.
The Daredevil Chicken Club was definitely a variety on the word variety. I must say, it wasn't entirely what I was expecting, but it was good. Very entertaining. They definitely included the crowd. Yeah, very different, very warm in there, getting very sweaty, definitely showed. It's massively entertaining, though.
I love La Tigre. It's fantastic. It's a great concept, and it's working really, really well.
I'm Louise Kerr, and my show is Sport Susie, and it's an aerobics comedy show inspired by Jane Fonda.
Hello everyone, my name's Shep Huntley, and I'm at the Christchurch Buskers Festival for two reasons. I'm a sideshow performer, so I'm doing a late night cabaret in the casino at 12 o'clock every night, and I'm also a street performer, so I'm doing daytime shows for family audiences and boys and girls and mums and dads here in the Hagley Park through the daytime. So I'm here for two reasons.
Hello, my name is Fraser Hooper, and I'm a clown, and it's a very interactive show. I play a lot with the audience.
I'm Richard Till, and I work at the Buskers Festival as both a stage manager and a backstage caterer.
Hi, my name's Amelia Cadwallader, and I'm here at the Buskers Festival with two acts. One of them is Maple Staple Gun. It's a physical comedy show mixed with hula hoops. My other act is called Las Cosas Nostra, the show. It's a duo show that I do with my partner, Francisco Vita.
We are the Vava sisters.
I'm Adrienne Truscott.
And I'm Tanya Gagné, otherwise known as Cirque du TNA.
the only two-girl circus in the world. And we perform a lot for grown-ups, shall we say.
Yes.
But we love coming out to the kids, too.
We do. And we made a street show that's largely about how men in this world make a lot more money than ladies. Yeah?
That's right.
And we do a little spin-off on that.
That's right.
Where we become male street performers. We go from ladies to men.
That's right. We sing songs, we do acrobatics, we do doubles trapeze, we change costumes a million times, and we just cause mayhem everywhere we go. That's kind of our...
Mayhem and merriment.
That's right. Mayhem and merriment.
My name is Sam Wills. I'm otherwise known as the boy with tape on his face. My act means I gaffer tape my mouth shut and I do silent, surreal comedy that involves interaction from the audience and use of everyday props as different things. Having the tape on for an hour, it's not too bad. I've gotten used to it. Sort of makes you, you know, obviously shut up, but and I can't even get a cold. That's the only thing I'm really aware of. I cannot get sick, because if my nose gets blocked, then I die. I started street performing 15 years ago, it would be, or I went to the circus school here at Christchurch and I studied juggling. And then after finishing there, I ended up staying on and teaching at the school for a couple of years, where I became a street performer here in Christchurch, working at the Art Centre and in the Casual Mall occasionally. Yeah. For me, what I love most about this festival is the audiences, that they really come out and they really support it. It's like I've done a lot of other festivals around the world, and of course they're all normally very well attended, but there's something about this festival that has possibly the biggest sense of community to it, where everyone wants to support it and they come on board and they make, it just becomes like it is a 10-day event where people are there to see as much as they can and really enjoy it. And it's a great feeling to be able to know that what I'm doing, people like. I think that's another reason why I think most people become performers, especially in this sort of world of, you know, it's all about look at me, like me for being who I am kind of thing. This is what I want to do. And by you clapping and cheering, affirms my choices.
When you get pulled up on stage, it's always a bit sort of freaky to start with, you know, walking up there. But once you're up there and just the atmosphere and the crowd, it was good fun.
Hello, I'm Daniel Craig from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada.
I'm Kimberly Craig from Chicago, USA.
We're the Street Circus Act, and we live in Canada now, and it's our second time in Christchurch.
Yeah, we do kind of an all-over circus show. We do hula hoops and steer wheel and juggling and hand-to-hand acrobatics and contortion and just everything that we can possibly do that's circus-related.
We try to bring the whole, like, Cirque du Soleil kind of attitude to the street without the exorbitant ticket prices is how it works, so.
Yeah.
Look at this field full of people. There's probably about 32,000 people here.
Oh, and a stunt, Brianna.
Hello.
Hi.
There. Hello.
Oh, doing a little dance on here.
Come here. Come here. Get in the case. Get in the case, little kid. Come on, get in.
I always wanted one. Hi.
Hey.
What's yours?
No. Give her back. But you know what we'll do? Here's a toy for you to play with so you don't get bored. Yeah, here's a toy. Here's a toy for you to play with so you don't get bored. That's for you. Yeah. No, you crazy child. All right.
Hi guys, I'm Max.
This is Cam,
and we are Gave These
Guys $5.
And we just performed on the Telecom Beer Busker stage.
Yeah.
And we say, hey, this is where we want to be. Righty, righty, can't let it breathe. Yeah, keep that clapping, make it some history.
I started to juggle. I was friends with Max and he was singing and playing guitar.
Yep.
and we thought it'd be a good idea to join together and try to make some money at a more disabled one. I guess we were kind of inspired by the Buskers Festival.
Yeah,
we've been coming to this for years.
I was inspired with my juggling, that's how I started. A guy here at the World Buskers Festival.
We had to audition and we put in a video and we got told we could do it. It was very cool.
It was really good.
We got to know all about it and all the prizes and stuff. It's been working so hard for it. It's really great.
There's some really cool people who run this and the other performers.
Yeah,
really great,
great to
stuff.
Meet them.
Hi there, my name is Adam.
And my name is Jim, and we are from the Kids Show What Now, and we're lucky enough this year to be the MCs for the Kids Pitch, just going on behind us there. Across all of New Zealand, we sent the call out for kids to put together a buskers performance, and we've auditioned across the country and gotten it down to, I think, it's about 8 or 9 different groups, and every day we get a few of them along and they do a 15-minute segment. And we've had singers, we've had jugglers, like, they're just as good as the adult performers, eh?
That's the thing, and it's so cool because I think the Buskers Festival will be here in another, like, 15 years' time after
seeing
those performers.
And they will be the buskers.
And they will be the buskers.
And you remember when you're younger, you, like, watch a busker and you feel really inspired by it. And these young people are just already taking action and they're, oh, so much talent. It's awesome.
We have been getting some wicked crowds here.
We've got our own wee thing going on.
It's so cool.
Throwing eggs and cream pies and it's good.
Nice, yeah.
So Kids Pitch 2012 is where it's at so far.
You gonna make some noise if I nail it?
Yeah.
What's that gonna sound like? Show me. That's not good enough. Try again. That's the same, but I'm so cheap. Here we go. Watch the left leg, the yellow pin, my forehead, and this section of the stage. As we shall come together in perfect unison. One, two, almost three. There you go. One, two, three. Make some noise! And now, come on tonight.
My name's Ashish Shalevan. I'm the host of the Midnight Carnival, which is a burlesque comedy sideshow circus thing we're doing here in the Christchurch Casino, which is miraculously still standing, which is a late night, really dirty knees up show, which really couldn't be put on any other place at any other time.
Of contortion and hula hoops, aerials and acrobatics probably sums it up, but that's not just it. So I'm involved with this fabulous Midnight Carnival as well as during the day in the aerial show, which is strangely enough also a carnival, clockwork carnival. Busy girl, 3 shows a day, but loving every minute of it. So it's fabulous seeing Christchurch come to life, and I look forward to it every January.
This is a rusty old dingo trap that I managed to smuggle in from Australia, and every night I've been slamming my arm down into it for the entertainment of our wonderful crowds here in the casino. Also have another name, which is the man with the iron skin. I bruise a lot less than you would. I think it's basically because I've just been doing it for years and years and years. Yeah. The other traps that I use are rabbit traps, which are basically just a smaller version of this. Yeah. And depending on the occasion, I put them on different parts of my anatomy. And my friend did it, and he said he'll never do it again. Cut a long story short, he'll never do it again. Yeah, but you gotta do something for a living. So that's it.
This is my wife, this is Gypsy Wood. She's
Hi.
The burlesque element of our show.
Got many costumes made from all over the world, and each crystal has to be put on individually. It just takes hours and hours. That's all part of being a burlesque dancer. My favorite thing about doing burlesque is getting naked. Because society tells women they're not allowed to be sexy and they're not allowed to be naked, and it's really a natural thing. And if you have that passion for such a thing, you shouldn't feel bad about it, and you should find a burlesque club and let yourself be free. Oh,
Riley Verlaine, and I am a burlesque dancer, producer, choreographer, and general hussy. Before burlesque, I was a ballet dancer. I had extensive ballet training in the States, and I ended up at a show one night. There was an amazing singer there who I wanted to see, and I met two girls who really stood out from this lineup of many, many dancers, and they were the Atomic Bombshells, and they made me very nervous. I felt very homely next to them. I was like, who are you? I mean, they're like 6 feet tall with hair, you know, out to here. And I introduced myself and told some stupid story to this girl about how I used to be a dancer, and she said, you should audition for us. So I did, and a month later I was opening for Dita Von Teese. P.S. I didn't even know who Dita Von Teese was at the time that we opened for her. This monstrosity here is the culmination of this big dream project that I had for a long time. I always wanted to be emerging from a huge stargazer lily, and this is one piece of a larger whole. And it is a long and painful process to put it on every day, and it is a delight to take it off for all of you. I love that part.
Thank God or whoever that earthquake was 3 weeks after the World Buskers Festival, because there were thousands and thousands of people in the center city in January. And I think it could have been so much worse.
Yeah, so on February 22nd when that earthquake struck, my first thoughts were obviously friends and family and the Buskers team who were in the Arts Centre and very close to home. And we'd just come off the previous Buskers Festival. I mean, we were still kind of on that slight anticlimax when you've just finished a huge event and the artists have only just left the country.
That was like 2 weeks after we had left, and we had been here and we experienced like a 5.6 in the YMCA on the top floor, and it lasted for like 4 or 5 seconds, and so we experienced like what it's like to have an earthquake here.
We were in Adelaide doing the Fringe Festival when the quake hit, the biggie one, and we were about to go down and do shows, but we ended up getting stuck in front of a TV on the phone trying to make sure everyone was all right, and yeah, it was pretty horrible.
So it was pretty quickly thought, what if? And we were very lucky when you look at all our venues that we used to have in the city, they're all by an extremely beautiful heritage site, like the Christchurch Cathedral, like the Arts Centre, Victoria Square, and now we haven't been to see those spots for some time, so.
Kind of jet lagged and got up in the morning, just news or internet, and then the steeple had gone down in Cathedral Square, and is that Christchurch?
Coming here yesterday and seeing the damage, it definitely, I mean, it's crippled downtown completely.
It's really hard seeing the whole cathedral, because I always had that thing about they're just buildings, that the whole city is more about people than buildings. But when you actually see the buildings, you go, it's quite a large part of the city. So it's kind of different.
It was one of our last shows from last year, and we didn't have a huge crowd, but we were having a lot of fun like we normally try to with a smaller audience.
It's strange, because I did a lot of my shows here when out of the festival as well. It's like that was the local pitch, where we'd all queue up in the morning, and I actually worked out the finale of my street show doing shows there. And Felicity used to perform right here, and then also during the festival, so you know, the crowds here were always the biggest and the coolest. I always found they were great in here. It's hard to look at it, but it's also good to know that there's a whole bunch of people in here fixing it, so at least you kind of know that it is on the way to not just getting completely flattened, that there are some really good people doing good stuff.
I have confidence that it's all gonna come back together, but it's going to take a few years.
As we said in our show, one thing that's really struck us is that people have come up to us and said, thank you for coming back. And, you know, we say thank you for still being here, because, as you know, as we just said, it would have been so easy to leave when your house falls on your head, right? But the people who are here come up to us and they say, we really need this. We really needed a stress-free place to go and have some fun and to have a laugh and to bring our families.
It's been an interesting year. It's really great that the festival still goes on, you know. No matter what, no quakes gonna stop us, so
We've been quite conscious that if there is a major earthquake, another one, all our facilities may be of benefit to the city. So we kind of turn instantly into a civil defence headquarters. But also our planning has just been meticulous in terms of energy, I guess, and generators, and being able to keep the show going. I think after so many aftershocks now, we're quite used to them, and I think if people are together, they're just going to stay together, especially if they're outside. So our health and safety plan is extremely rigorous, aims to keep the show moving. We don't really want to have to shut up shop and send everyone home. We think the best place for people to be if something happens would be at the Buskers Festival.
I worked Restart Mall just before the festival, and it sort of seemed like the vibe in town was that people were ready to come out and, you know, get their families out of the houses and just have a bit of a good time in the park here. So, no, I'm thrilled to be part of it, eh?
You know, you see people who have been through a lot. A good laugh just puts everything into perspective. It's like, okay, cool, so, you know, things are broken, shit's a bit fucked up, but that's okay because, you know, we've got laughter, we've got love. Love and laughter, right? Two things. Love, laughter. Together, heaven. Okay, shush.
So you're asking us how we got started. Well,
born into it,
yeah. Our mum showed us most of her dance moves because dad left when he was pretty young.
I was only a baby. Mum taught us some dances, but she basically fell apart at the seams.
Yeah, I stepped up. I became a man pretty young.
So we've been doing this all our lives, and it's just gotten better and better every year. Hey, bro?
Telling you.
Travel all over the world.
You know, if you bought our DVD, you'll see the show filmed in Canada, Australia, photographs from around the world, basically. Although we like to tour in Ireland occasionally, you know, you got to keep it real for the fans.
We're a really big deal in Tasmania.
Maybe we should just move straight on to our solo. I should have rehearsed this year. This is not going to work out.
I'm not ready, Sean! No, just keep going!
For some reason, my breakdancing always gets a good reaction.
Yeah. Sometimes people laugh at our show, but I don't really know why. It's just a dancing show. People get excited.
People often think, though, don't they, that we've gotten where we are today just because we're so good looking.
That is not the only reason. It's also because we have amazing fashion sense.
Here it's evolved that every time we change country, we have to tweak it, and in tweaking it, we find new material.
The Christchurch audiences are amazing, and the artists will tell you they really do kind of respect and reward artists for their talent. And I think it has a lot to do with our culture as a city, with the arts centre and Scared Scriptless and Circo Arts, which is the circus school based at the Christchurch Polytechnic. But also now that we've had sort of 18 years and we're into our 19th, we're really generating some strong kind of education that they can trust the talent here will completely amaze them and that it is world class. So it's, while some people think busking is, you know, a little bit amateur, Christchurch audiences know that the buskers that come to Christchurch are the best in the world, and it's getting that kind of reputation.
And in Pakistan, Suresh is worried that one of his testicles is much bigger than the other.
This is private, just one moment. There's an irregularity, one end's definitely... Madam, you can help us out here. Just one of you ladies, one of you lovely ladies here, if you just like to balance one in each hand, would be really, really... You look like you were going to do it for a minute there, I saw that! There was a flicker of recognition, madam, I saw it! Wow. Always like that, never like that. Yes, no, yes, no. What a skanky mole. It's all right, no, it's fine. Do you have skanky moles? Have you got moles over here? You got moles, don't you? Yeah? It's like a bogan, a female bogan. He's a mole, no? Yes? All right, fair enough. What's your name, madam? Mole. Molly! Molly! I'll leave you alone.
Yeah. Audiences are awesome here.
Yeah, they're fantastic.
If you have a good show, they are going to go with you all the way with it.
Yeah, they're some of the best audiences in the world because they're educated. Festival's, what, 19 years old or something. So what you're getting is adults who are now bringing their kids, but the adults came when they were kids. So we're getting this second generational thing of, oh, I went there when I was a kid, so now I'm going to take my kids.
They're gonna like go with you on the ride.
Yeah, it's like they want you to have a good show. They're not there with any cynicism. It's like, please let this be a great show. So if it's a great show and a performer takes them on a great ride, then they're gonna be up for it.
And I heard they're getting more and more generous every day this week. Yeah, they're great in every way, in their hearts and with their wallets.
Yeah,
so that's great.
Yeah.
This is a form of entertainment where you get to see the show before you pay. You know, there's no other type of entertainment that you couldn't ever walk into an orchestra venue and I'll pay afterwards. I'll pay when I see I'll figure out what I think it's worth and pay you then.
That's the thing about street theater busking is it's pretty immediate feedback because they have no reason to stay. So they haven't paid for a ticket. They're probably on their way to somewhere else. So if you don't keep their interest somehow, they're going to walk away.
The type of festival that I like is the audience that likes to see theater. So they know, like, people are coming, they're going to come down to this park because they know that they want to have a theatrical experience. There are some busker festivals that might be a little less supported by the community, and so it feels a lot more like a real busking show where you're kind of stopping people to convince them to watch your show.
The audience here has been groomed really elegantly to like welcome everybody and be really supportive. So as performers, we just feel like we're playing to this gorgeous audience.
Yeah, we feel at home, and it feels very like what we do feels very celebrated and very like everyone seems really excited for us to be here.
The shows have to be good to come down here, partly because it's 19 years old, so the audiences are not going to put up with a half-baked show. You know, it has to be a good quality show.
The audiences are very discerning here. So they want quality and they want something that is going to be different than what they've seen before.
Yeah. I'm really enjoying it. It's real cool and it's hilarious. Fantastic. It's really funny. It's enjoyable. Very enjoyable.
I love the people. Two lots of people. The Christchurch public, they're one of the best audiences in the world. And also all the artists and the people that organize this festival have become sort of friends over the years.
Major festival that a lot of performers talk about trying to do.
It really is one of the best festivals in the world. It's 10 days. They treat the performers really well.
For the Northern Hemisphere, this is very famous in the performing world. The World Buskers Festival.
Like, start with the location, where it is. It's in New Zealand. It's in the summertime, where it's winter, where you live. The festival itself is greatly structured. It's not like other festivals where you spend like all day on the pitch waiting for your turn. You do only one or two shows, and then at night you do a group show together. You're encouraged to try new material. The audience, since they've been exposed to street performing for 20 years, are really receptive. You don't have to bullshit them. and hype them up. You know, you can just go out and do your show.
Every year I'm always amazed. I'm always astounded by some of the acts that turn up. It's really quite a unique experience, the Buskers.
There's just so many. They're all so unique and so brilliant in their own ways.
We love the World Buskers Festival!
The strangest thing. Oh gosh.
The strangest thing.
I don't know if we can say that.
What's the weirdest thing that somebody, it wasn't weird, it was just rude. It was downright rude. A kid came up and put his
hash in our hat.
Hashish, put it in the hat.
Some weed, and I don't know what happened to it.
But it caught a woman in the hat.
Some gummy worms in the hat.
Religious literature, put it in the hat.
Yeah, weed and drugs. And
cupcakes and muesli bars. And
knickers and bras, and I don't know, silly stupid stuff. But
coins from over 100 years ago.
Range SMM parties to condoms to, you know, religious invitations.
He had a photo shop. So he took pictures of our show, raced back to his shop, got them done and brought them out to us. But it just really freaked me out, you know, because I was just, that was just a show we just did.
Yeah.
A lot of time we get like trinkets and stuff off kids, which is really nice. Like, I don't have anything, but here's this bracelet I want you to have.
The woman had taken a photo of that moment where the guy was laying down and I was cutting a cucumber. And so she put the CD in there of that moment. And then when I loaded up the photo and had a look at it, the guy laying down had a massive erection.
In Japan, you'll get all these people have really spent hours and hours making this thing and give it to you and put it in your hat.
A little girl also came up with really sticky fingers with a 10-cent piece and tried to put it in the hat and it wouldn't come off her fingers because it was really sticky.
Someone sat in my crowd and drew me with the Flinders Street Station in the background in real detail in pencil with shading.
Put a small chocolate Santa in the hat and it melted all over the money. Looked like I had in my hands.
It was a mess. It was a bad, bad mess.